How has information technology affected sports?
Is he going to get the touch? No, he's not. Oh, no! He's got it!
Home field stand. Touchdown.
Usain Bolt nicht zu halten. Nein, er gewinnt.
What are future innovations in sports information technology? Has the influence of information technology on sports made games more fair, exciting, and easier to follow? Or has technology caused too much delay, slowing down games, and creating a disconnect between the viewers and the event?
A absolutely horrible call. A perfect game taken away.
Officials, coaches, and fans have relied on information technology for years. TV has had the largest impact on sports, transforming many sports from pastime competitions to multi-billion dollar industry made up of multi-million dollar franchises with fans around the world.
HDTVs have provided just amazing like view of the game. The camera technology used at the game where you have the cameras that are give you the really close-up views on the HD. Watching it in home, I mean, it's in some ways it's better than being at the game.
Would you rather be at the game?
That's a nice read by
but not, it's raining there. It's not raining in my study habit.
You get the really close-up views. You can, now with like TiVo, you can rewind it and watch a play again. And of course they do the instant replays over and over again, which is one thing that when I'm watching football, I don't necessarily like seeing the play over and over and all the stoppages.
Sports are a major part of the entertainment industry, and the proof is in the players' and coaches' salaries. Replay technology has created a whole subset of entertainment, where sportscasters, fans, and athletes can analyze every detail of every play or race and make arguments and judgments on what could have been done.
Closing situations, we were talking about totality.
Darren Sharper, hope it did for Seattle right now, for T-Brad, for all them Seahawks. Though, no, you can't take me down. You need more than that. Hey, little boy, damn, a Superman, though.
In the last decade or so, the internet and social media have played a significant role in the way people follow sports.
I think the way technology is changing how people are viewing sports are a couple of different ways. One is access to information about players. You know, now I can, as soon as any player is mentioned, I can look up their history, their stats, really kind of experience much more about them. It's also plugged into this whole broader issue of what I think people call social TV. Which is basically people live tweeting or Facebooking about a live sporting or other type of event, right? Sporting events and political events are kind of the two most common ones of these. And so, for instance, if the Lions are playing on Thanksgiving and are about to lose again, you know, there's a lot of people on Twitter talking about that, and you can kind of feel part of that shared community of sports watchers, unlike in the past where it could be just you or your friends at home watching the game. So that kind of shared access and shared story making through social media is another big change. And then, you know, kind of that access of how do I watch the game and how do the mass media report social media back has been a real big issue as well. So a good example is, you know, most college sports athletics departments really worry about what coaches, athletic directors, and players say on Twitter, because NCAA rules are so strict that it takes a real kind of, and the rules aren't very clear about how to use social media. So everybody kind of holds their breath every time anybody tweets anything to see what's going to happen. But that does create a different layer of access. So for instance, you know, you can follow Denard Robinson's Twitter feed and just get an entirely different level of access to that player than you would have had it 10 years ago.
On December 5th, 2012, the Michigan Football Facebook page became the first college football page to gain over 1 million fans, proving that social media now has a major role in how fans get information about popular and more obscure athletics. Social media has allowed fans from around the world to come together and discuss or argue about their favorite players and teams. Recently, a system has been developed that can project a first down line using lasers. This line would be seen by both fans, players, and officials on the field. Here, officials and coaches discuss the pros and cons of laser first down technology. Information technology has changed the way sports are officiated. In track, races are precisely timed using electronic starting guns and photo finishes. Swimming has long depended on sensor pad timing, which comes in handy when a race is won by hundreds of a second. Information technology has allowed sports to grow into a massive entertainment industry. It has led to better officiating and more exciting TV. The internet has made endless statistics and replays available to everyone, and social networks have created a virtual space for fans to interact. In some cases, information technology has slowed down some sports or created an overabundance of information. However, advanced technology has made sports easier to officiate and to follow, and it has made sports more exciting to watch.
Jetzt aus dem Blöcken, jetzt kommt Geh, und jetzt ist Usain Bolt nicht.